Marvel, please hire me. You know, like any Marvel film I think would be incredible.
You've starred in so many incredible films, which we're going to get into shortly. But let's start off with a classic, one that never fails to make me cry, Gifted.
Stop. I'm sorry. I made a mistake.
Are you a crier when it comes to films?
Not particularly, actually. If a film makes me cry, I'm very surprised. Hey, I like this film if it does make me cry.
So what's a film that does make you cry then, if you're quite hard to crack?
I can't think of one off the top of my head. I can't think of one. Whenever Ghostbusters came out, because I was so happy. So I was a little bit hysterical.
Ghostbusters is great, but also Stick the Notebook on, you'll have a good cry.
I love The Notebook. That's like an all-time favorite.
Because Chris Evans is essentially family, does that mean you can just send him memes?
No, I literally, it's been so long since just recently I spoke to Mr. Chris again over email, I think, but it's been a while. I have not like talked to him in a good minute. I'd love to work with him again though. I think he's brilliant.
You can just get your phone, text him some memes. Be like, hi, I'm still here.
That'd be hilarious.
But it must have been such an amazing set to be on. Do you remember the first moment you walked onto a film set and fell in love with acting?
I think that it's always been a passion for me, and I don't really know why. But I can't think of the moment that I fell in love with it, but now looking back, I'm working on something right now, and it's a very strange work week. It's Wednesday through Sunday, which is strange. So Monday and Tuesday I have off. And so tomorrow is my Monday, and I'm so excited to go to work. Like now looking back, I'm just so happy with what I do. And that just brings so much joy to my heart that I love what I do so much. Like over the summer, shooting A Friend of the Family was a real big thing for me, because I feel like I've learned a lot about acting and about filmmaking on this series. And I'm so thankful for that. It's genuinely one of my favorite things I've done.
And you're so good at it. You're so good. And the projects that you choose are so brilliant.
Thank you. And I don't think that it's choose. I'm just lucky to like be on them.
I want to hurt them so badly. Gilead. And then...
We've got to talk next about The Handmaid's Tale, because what an incredible series to be a part of. It's such an intense series. Do you do anything offset to kind of de-stress?
Okay, well, pretty much I have my dog on set with me 24/7. If I'm stressed out, I have him. And the sets with darker subject matter, I find, are usually more light and airy and fun, because you have to be whenever you're shooting something like that. So
that's what dogs are there for.
Exactly. Maybe Gizmo will come and say hi in a moment.
Oh, I'd love that. But the fan base is just huge for The Handmaid's Tale. What's the most common thing you get fans coming up to you saying?
I just am always excited to talk about the show with anyone. So whatever anybody wants to talk to me about, I'm just excited to talk about acting and Handmaids.
We need to get Gizmo in there.
I know, right? Little Handmaid's Tale cap for him.
Get him his own trailer and everything. Hopefully we'll see him in the next season.
I think he'll make a
star,
great
the new star.
The new star.
Oh, he's gorgeous. He's beautiful.
Oh my gosh. No, don't kiss me. I'm in an interview.
He's going back to rehearse for the next season.
Oh, jeepers.
Where do you think you're going?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Don't tell me what you have to do. I paid for you to skate. You're going to stay on the ice and skate.
We can't not talk about I, Tonya. It's one of my favourite movies, and you've got to work with some incredible actors like Margot Robbie. But what's one of the best pieces of advice you've been given from another actor?
I mean, I've gotten lots of advice from so many people that have really shaped who I am today. Octavia Spencer would always look out for me on Gifted, and she really helped the way that I look at reviews of films. So I just don't really read many reviews. And if I read the good ones, then I have to read the bad ones too, is what she said. So I do. Honestly, Mr. Colin Hanks on this show, A Friend of the Family, was always really there for me. And gave me a lot of advice. And it's so annoying because I feel like I always want to be like, yeah, somebody said this to me, but it's just beautiful to have another actor there and just to watch them act and see the way that they do things on set and just pick up on their nuances and things that make them so brilliant. And it's just being around these incredible people has really shaped who I am today.
And just soaking it all up must be amazing.
I'm only human.
Just a small movie, part of something called the MCU. I don't know if you've heard of it. Captain Marvel.
I don't know. Is that like a little indie or something?
Yeah, I think it is. How special is the bond between you and Brie?
It was really incredible to be a part of that. Unfortunately, I did not get to see her that much since I was the younger version. There was not a lot of overlap, but she was really nice. She didn't even have to, but she did come and visit me in the hair and makeup trailer and talk to me, and she gave me like a little Marvel picture that they ended up freaking out a little bit about because I was not supposed to have that, but it was really kind of her. And you know, she's incredible. I think that she's just brilliant. I'm honored to have played a younger version of her.
She's so cool and badass. But it's such an important film in the sense that so many young girls will grow up wanting to be as fearless as Captain Marvel. Which film has had the biggest impact on you growing up?
I've always been like a horror, a little freak. I always loved the horror films. Maybe because I watched Alien and Ripley was just such a cool main character to see. So I think that could have been something special for me.
This is Ripley, last survivor of the Nostromo, signing off.
And that is a really special film, Captain Marvel. And I'm so happy to have been a part of that and to be able to go back and watch it and be like, wow, that is such a cool character to have to look up to, even for me.
I love that you're a horror fan as well. You're a lot braver than me. Can't do them.
Oh my gosh, but it's so fun.
It must be the dream being in something like Captain Marvel. Which other Marvel film would you have loved to have been spliced into just to experience?
Marvel, please hire me. You know, like any Marvel film I think would be incredible. But it's funny because honestly, out of everything I've done, I always find that the darker, more dramatic roles are what I gravitate towards and are so fun for me. I don't know why.
Yeah, I feel like those are the funnest characters to play because they're so meaty.
Yeah, and there's so much to do. And I feel like if sometimes watching it, you're uncomfortable, then that's important. Because if you're uncomfortable with this story, then why aren't we doing more for the uncomfortable stories in real life? So I'm always honored to be a part of shows like Handmaids and A Friend of the Family, two of my favorite things I've ever done.
Another iconic film you've starred in is Ghostbusters Afterlife.
Why should you never trust Adams? Because they make up everything.
You've done such a diverse range of films and TV shows. What's something you'd love to do in the future that you haven't done yet?
I would love to do something that is musical. I think that is a goal for me. I've been writing a lot of music for the films I've been in more recently since I've gotten into music, but I'd love to do a musical. I think that'd be cool.
What's your favorite musical as a musical geek myself?
I loved Tick, Tick, Boom. I loved that. I thought that it was so good. And I constantly play the songs at my piano.
Hi, welcome. I'm Jonathan Larson.
And Andrew Garfield is just brilliant.
Oh, I mean, amazing.
Chef's kiss.
Chef's kiss.
Finally, A Friend of the Family. I have been hooked on this series.
Who is her father? Him or me?
I can't believe it's a true story. How much more pressure do you feel playing a real life person like Jan compared to a fictional character?
Honestly, a lot. It was definitely scary coming into it. And that was my first question to our showrunner and producer was, you know, is Jan and her family a part of this? Because I don't know if personally I would be comfortable playing her without her consent and sign off. And she has been such a brilliant, big part of this, which means so much to all of us. And it's amazing to be able to have such access to her and to be able to ask her and make sure that I'm doing her right. Cause that's my biggest thing, is I want to make sure that I'm playing her how she wants it to be. And she really gave all of us a lot of freedom to play the character instead of really, really toning into every single bit. She was like, it's okay. You know, I know that you guys are actors and I'm giving you the send off to do what you want with this. And the first time I ever talked to her, I talked to her for 2 hours and she just told me so much. And from day one, she has always been so open and honest with me and all of us. And that meant the world to me to be able to have her and to be able to message her and be like, did you read the sides for today? Are you fine with this scene? How are you feeling? And I'd send her pictures. I'd send her a picture of a costume versus what she had worn in real life and be like, look how like cool and similar this is. And then she would give me just a whole backstory to that like dress. And I was like, that's so cool. And she's such a well-spoken and incredible human being that I just am honestly so happy to have in my life, even offset. I still talk to her often and I just think that she's incredible.
She's such a brave lady. And also to bring this story to the screen, an incredible, brave thing to do.
She's amazing. And it was amazing having her on set.
How emotionally challenging was this role for you? Because I was just gobsmacked at the things that I was watching. So I can't imagine how tough that must be and emotional as an actor stepping into her shoes.
It was a lot. It was crazy. And it was really interesting to play and to figure it out because it's such a complicated, layered relationship with every other character. Everything is just so layered and intense because that's how it was in real life. And it's so insane to think about. But I really talked to Jan a lot. And I was able to read her some of her diary entries from the time of the show. And I was able to read like some of the letters between her and B, which were crazy, and really be able to put myself in the mind space of what was going on in that moment. But we had an on-set counselor, therapist, and we had an intimacy coordinator. So there was always people there to talk to. And it was a very, very nice. Everybody on set was wonderful. So it was emotionally challenging at times, but our set was so lovely and everybody was just so close that it was nice to be there.
There's no telling what he is capable of. I'm
crazy. Thank you so much for talking to me. And it's great to hear about all of your past projects and keep smashing it.
Thank you so much. It was lovely talking with you.